What is up, my friends? It's Ray back here, and you know, I've reviewed quite a few Thunderbolt 5 docks in my setup lately, but this one right here might just be my new favorite so far. It's the 11-port Razer Thunderbolt 5 dock Mercury edition. I've been using it with my M.4 Pro Mac Mini for the past few weeks now, and what really surprised me about it is how perfectly it blends into my setup. Unlike Razer's main Thunderbolt 5 dock that includes RGB lighting, this Mercury edition is clean, minimal, and just exists on your desk, which I love. It's got enough power to run up to 3 4K displays, deliver up to 140 watts of charging, and it even hides an M.2 slot inside for high-speed solid-state storage. Before we go even further, let's roll it back to an unboxing and I'll show you guys the setup process. When this Thunderbolt 5 dock arrives inside the box, you're gonna find the dock itself, which again is super sleek in that silver finish. Plus, there's some documentation, a braided Thunderbolt cable for your computer, and the power supply. This dock has 10 ports in total. One upstream Thunderbolt 5 port, 3 downstream Thunderbolt 5 ports, 1 USB-C 3.2, 2 USB-A ports, a gigabit Ethernet port, a 3.5mm audio jack, and an SD card slot that's conveniently placed on the side. The coolest and arguably the most unique feature of this dock is that hidden M.2 slot. Here you can add up to 8 terabytes of additional storage space without adding any extra cables or enclosures. I installed a 2 terabyte Samsung M.2 SSD in here, and it was super easy to do. Setting this dock up is also a breeze. It's plug and play and compatible with both PC and Mac, so you can easily integrate it into your workflow. The hardest part for me, I would say, was managing and taming the cables, since everything in my setup is all tightly organized, but once you've done all that, the result is a clean, organized, and sophisticated looking space. All of the ports are in the back of this dock, so cables can easily be hidden. What I really appreciate is the SD card slot being on the side. I work a lot with SD cards, like I'm talking almost every single day, so the easy access to this port is amazing. What I really love about this dock though is how discreet it is. It perfectly matches my M4 Pro Mac Mini and even fits right under my Bololo setup cockpit stand, completely out of the way. My setup isn't anything crazy or over the top. My goal with it was to make something clean, minimal, and organized, and this dock helps keep it that way. I'd imagine that it would have no problem at all doing the same for setups that have more gear, especially more displays. The only drawback to it, I would say, is the price. This is definitely a premium Thunderbolt 5 dock, and on top of it, you do need to supply your own M.2 SSD for additional storage, so the price can add up. However, if you're building a serious workstation or creative setup, this dock is an excellent all-in-one solution. After a couple of weeks with this Razer Thunderbolt 5 dock in my setup, it checks just about all the right boxes. My Mac Mini setup is cleaner, faster, and more flexible than ever. Between this dock and my external SSD, I now have nearly 10 terabytes of external storage space right at my desk. This dock is sleek, it hides the cables, the port layout is excellent, the SD card slot is extremely handy, and that M.2 storage option is a huge bonus, especially if you're a content creator, a gamer, a video editor, or someone who works with huge files and wants to back them up. Everything you need is right here in this little box. It's super, super cool. Well, that's all I got, my friends. Thank you so, so much for watching. Now, I wanna know, what do you think of this Razer Thunderbolt 5 dock? Does it look like something that you would use? Drop a comment and let me know below. And if you enjoyed this video, you know the drill. Be sure to hit that like and subscribe button for much more coming your way soon. Until the next one, I will catch you guys later. Peace.